In a purport, Srila Prabhupada says, the purpose of the whole creation is to give facility for people to become Krishna conscious. And book distribution is a great facility in this direction. So many people around the world are getting an opportunity to hear about Krishna and to learn what it is to love God. There was one young man who got a book in Los Angeles, and he is the son of a big Christian preacher. And his mother also was very much a Christian. So she saw that he was reading this BTG, and she asked, "What is this you're reading?" And she took it from him, "What is this back to Godhead? You can't read this." So she took it away from him. He never saw it again, but he read about a page. And he was impressed. Sometime later, maybe about a month later or so, he got a book, Science of Self-Realization. He wanted to read this one, so he didn't let his parents see it. He kept it secret. He would read it at night and keep it hidden. So he read that and became convinced that Krishna is the Supreme Lord. So eventually he became a devotee, and he became a big, big preacher. So his father found out that he had become a Hare Krishna. So he called him, and he said, "Son, you grew up devoted to Christ. How can you give that up and become a Hare Krishna?" So this devotee's name he's a disciple of Prabhupada, Stumba. He made so many devotees. So he told his father, he said, "Father, for the first time in my life, I'm feeling some love for God." So his father said, "Well then, continue on, and I hope you have all success in developing your love for God." So the father had some integrity. Although he was a big Christian preacher, he had some integrity. He said, "Then continue on, and I hope you have all success." So this is the result of people coming in contact with Srila Prabhupada's books. People get purified. They get to learn who is God. Yeah. Most of us from the West, we haven't a clue. In India, you have some idea. Of course, there's so many gods in India, so it's a little difficult. Who is the Supreme, right? And Prabhupada was battling with that when he was preaching here before he went to the West. But then when he went to the West and so many people becoming devotees of Krishna, then people started thinking, well, maybe Krishna is the Supreme. So of course, he is the Supreme Lord. Mataparatang nanyat kinchidasti dananjaya. There is no true superior to me. Everything is resting on me. Shiva never says that. Brahma never says that. Ganesh never says that. Even Vishnu never says that. Krishna says it. So Krishna is the Supreme Lord. So by book distribution, we're giving people an opportunity to understand who God is and who they are. You want to hear another amazing story? There's one young man who has a father, he's a doctor. We're going back into the 1980s. His father was such a good doctor that he was also internationally known as a good doctor. So, the Hindu family, So two friends of his, they were in America going to a conference, and one devotee gave these men a BTGU. Now they're Buddhists, so what are we going to do with this magazine about Hinduism? So then they remembered, oh, we have a friend in Burma. He's a Hindu, so he might appreciate it. So they went back to Burma, and they gave this magazine to their friend, this doctor. And although he's Hindu, he put it on the table, never looked at it. His son, 17 years old, saw this magazine, picked it up, started looking through it, was impressed. Nice. Nice magazine. Beautiful. Liked it so much. In the magazine, there was a way that you can get a free book from Los Angeles. So he filled that out. He sent it to Los Angeles. You get a coming back book. About a month later, he goes back to his home, and there's a brahmachari sitting in his house, in his living room, holding this piece of paper. So this young man said, oh, I filled that out, hoping to get a free book, but I get you. Even better. So he started preaching to him. And he had many books. He could only stay there for one day, because at that time in Burma, you could only get a one-day visa. That was it. So he had to do some fast preaching. Sold the books to him. And then he left. So this young man, he's reading all these books. And he's very attracted. He becomes a devotee. But there's no devotees in Burma. So he goes to Singapore. He hears that there's some devotees in Singapore. So he flies to Singapore and he gets some training. Now in Singapore also, we're not allowed to have a temple, even to this day. But there's devotees there. So he learned, he got some contact. So he went to Singapore, got some training, went back to Burma. And he was so inspired by Krishna consciousness, by the philosophy of Krishna consciousness, that he went preaching all over Burma. And now, are we listening still? And now, in Burma, there's 12 temples. Because of this one devotee, there's 12 temples around Burma. There's so many devotees in Burma now because of this one BTG that was given to a Buddhist, given to his father who never read it. He read it, and now it's Burma's is booming with Krishna consciousness. So this is the power of Krishna consciousness. And Lord Chaitanya, he came to open the storehouse of love of God, right? He came for this purpose. So Lord Chaitanya came and he was preaching like anything, preaching up a storm like anything, right? So after some time, you know, Lord Chaitanya left, and then Apasampradayas came in. And gradually the storehouse of love of God that he had opened, the doors started closing, right? The doors started closing. So they almost closed, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur shows up. And then the doors start opening again. And then Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, his son, shows up. He appears, and they open up more. And then Srila Prabhupada shows up, and they open up wide. Right? They open up wide. So much so that now you can get books in China, you can get books in Russia, you can get books all over the world. And now, for the first time ever, thousands of books are going into the Middle East. Arabic books are being poured into Saudi Arabia and Bahrain and all these places where books were never going before, because these people, they're going into Los Angeles and cities all over the world, and devotees are distributing these Arabic books and people are taking them. So this is the mercy of Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Thank you, Vijay Prabhu. So the main purpose of today's event is to give out awards to our book distributors, both international and Mayapur devotees who participate in this wonderful effort of distributing the transcendental literature given to us by Srila Prabhupada. So we have with us senior devotees who, on behalf of Srila Prabhupada, on behalf of ISKCON, would like to appreciate the effort of the devotees who participate on daily basis in book distribution. So we will begin. Next person speaking will be His Holiness Gopal Krishna Maharaj.
How many people have spoken so far?
Only one. No one's spoken. There's a lot of prizes to give out, so we'll keep the talking short.
1 hour.
The full program is till 9.
Hare Krishna. Om Agyante Mirandasya Gyananjana Shalakya Chakshir Militaryena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobestam Stavidamena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadavayam Dati Swapadanikam Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivashare Gaur Bhaktivinoda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Sam Gari Yagya Ki. So we all assemble here today to thank. Is someone translating? Okay. So we all assemble here today to thank the devotees who have been helping fulfill Prabhupada's desire. Srila Prabhupada emphasized book distribution. Why? His spiritual master also did that. And Thakur Bhaktivinoda, great acharya, who re-established the pure teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he also set the example of book distribution. In 1896, the year that Prabhupada appeared, Bhaktivinoda Thakur sent a book that he wrote on the life of Lord Chaitanya to universities around the world. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur understood his father's mood, and he also understood the teaching of the scriptures. In the scriptures, it is clearly mentioned that if you want to please the Lord, we should be more merciful. Just like Prahlad Maharaj on numerous occasions said, I'm not worried about myself, but I'm worried about those who are trying to convert a position of distress to a position of comfort. And now the Muni says, if you want to please the Lord, Dayaya Sarvabhuteshu, be merciful in all living entities. Bhaktisiddhanta ji opened presses and he encouraged his disciples to preach. And in 1935, when he was leading a big Braj Mandal parikrama, Srila Prabhupada met him in Radhakund. And what did Bhaktisiddhanta ji do? Who knows? He drew a picture of a mridanga and he said, if Krishna gives you facilities, then publish and distribute books. Prabhupada took this instruction to heart. Even before going to the West, Prabhupada had published the first canto of Bhagavatam, and he himself was distributing these books in libraries, etc. Prabhupada was publishing a Bhakti-Gaudiya magazine that he founded in 1944. And he would regularly go out and distributed books himself. Prabhupada took his spiritual master's instruction to heart, and on numerous occasions he emphasized the importance of preaching and book distribution. Prabhupada said, "If you want to please me, distribute by books." There are innumerable letters of Prabhupada where he emphasizes this. Sometimes people think the Hare Krishnas are after money. They just come. They just want to sell distribute the books. The reason why our acharyas and the scriptures emphasize book distribution is because these books contain knowledge spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead and explained further by Prabhupada and the acharyas. So, if people read the words of the Supreme Lord, then they get inspired to take to the platform of devotional service. Thousands of devotees all over the world have come to this movement by being introduced to these books. When I walked in, Vijay Prabhu was revealing some pastimes in which, through book distribution, people have taken to Krishna consciousness all over the world. In Africa, our devotees have gone to Africa to preach in one country. And before they could preach, and when they started preaching, they discovered that some individuals, when they were studying in England, they bought the books and they already started preaching. And people were already introduced to Krishna consciousness, even though we did not have any center there. So book distribution is our most important activity. There are many activities that we can engage in. But of all the activities, book distribution is most important. Why? Because these books contain deep philosophy. Prabhupada presented the philosophy as it is, without any distortion. And Prabhupada wanted these books to be translated in all the languages of the world and these books to be made available to everyone. So the Vaishnava's desire is to save suffering humanity. Para dukha dukhi. A devotee is sad when he sees that people are trying to engage in material sense enjoyment. But he knows that the human form of life is very rare. So there are innumerable examples. Sometimes we feel that we are hesitant in taking part in book distribution. But an important element is enthusiasm. We should be enthusiastic to preach. And when enthusiastic to preach, Krishna from the heart will inspire you to preach and be successful. So book distribution was emphasized by our acharyas and Prabhupada and the devotees of this Krishna conscious movement all over the world are taking part in this activity. In the month of December, we have Gita Jayanti, and connected to Gita Jayanti, our devotees take part in book distribution marathons. And because devotees are making an effort, they also have success. So book distribution is our most important activity. Prabhupada said, "If you want to please me, distribute my books." Because when we distribute these books, we give Prabhupada the opportunity to preach. And these books help us to maintain our spiritual life, and they help others to come to Krishna consciousness also. So we should also regularly read these books. That's an important element. Sometimes we feel, oh, we need to read some other books to get complete knowledge. Prabhupada on numerous occasions said, everything you need to know is there in my books. So we should have full faith that everything we need to know to go back to Godhead, to save the conditioned souls, is there in Prabhupada's books. So we should make it a habit of regularly reading these books and regularly taking part in book distribution. If the temple leaders promote book distribution, if they talk about book distribution, devotees get inspired. And we have discovered that besides the temple devotees, our congregation can play a big role in book distribution. We have experienced that the congregation members in the marathon time take time out from their jobs, businesses, and they are happy to take part in book distribution. In the Bhagavatam, you see the example. Lord Rishadeva says, a gentleman, if he sees a blind man walking on the wrong path, what does he do? He catches his hand and puts him on the right path. So we have knowledge, but we should distribute this knowledge. The best way to distribute this knowledge is through preaching and book distribution. So let us dedicate ourselves to book distribution. Let us be fully convinced that everything we need to know is in Prabhupada's books. Regularly read Prabhupada's books and take part in book distribution. And now Prabhupada's books, as we just heard, are available in more than 60 languages of the world. And in all the major languages we have Prabhupada's books. So everyone is getting the opportunity to read these books and make progress on the journey back to Godhead. Sabkaniya kya ki? Vyar bhadanga ki? Ghor Premananda.
Thank you, Gopal Krishna Maharaj. So here in India, amongst our GBC leaders, His Holiness Gopal Krishna Maharaj, His Holiness Japataka Maharaj, and His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj are the ones who push this transcendental book distribution a lot, very, very actively, hands-on. So we would like to extend a special gratitude to the three of them for having these wonderful events and allowing us to participate in book distribution. Thank you, Maharaj. So today we're going to have around 20 awards given out by Vijay Prabhu to various temples from all over the world, and around 40 awards coming out from Mayapur for our various book distributors. So that's a lot of blessings to give out, a lot of blessings to shower by all of you. So we will request Nrsimha Prabhu to speak shortly on behalf of the international BBT. And
Hare Krishna. I don't really want to take any of your time, but I want to give the opportunity to our God brother who's producing the books in the Arabic languages in the Middle East.
Thank you, Nrsimha Prabhu. On November 9th, 1976, in Srila Prabhupada's room in Vrindavan, Prabhupada heard that a standing order of his books made it into a Muslim university. And when he heard that, he interrupted the person and said, "Muslim." And then he made a statement that everyone has heard, that anyone who helps preach in the Muslim world, I take the dust from their feet and put it on my head. So I'm humbled to be in the presence of such stalwart, determined book distributors. And I humbly request if you could consider adding one Arabic book at least in your life to get that special blessing from Prabhupada. It will make everything else in your life easy, and the book distribution will flow much better, because Prabhupada never made such a blessing. I am your servant, and we will provide as many Arabic books as you can distribute. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Let me introduce, this is Bhima Prabhu. He has been doing BBT service for a very long time. He is always supporting and helping Sri Mayapur Chandradaya Mandir with all our needs, so we are very, very grateful. We have good book scores because Bhima Prabhu always gives us good discounts on the books, as well as, no, Bhakti Purushottamaya says not good enough discounts. So, well. So we appeal, give us better discounts so we can do better next. But he gives sufficient books and good quality books. So we are very, very grateful. There's, on discounts, there is still some discussion going on. Bhima Prabhu ki.
So the other day, I was looking at the logo that was made by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur for the Gaudiya Math. Have you ever seen that? At the top it has Lord Chaitanya, and then it's divided into two halves. So on one half there's a picture of Lakshmi Narayan in Vaikuntha, and it says Vaidhi. And then under that there's a bell and the items for worshiping in the temple. And that's the Pancharatriki Vidhi Marg. And then the other half, there's a picture of Radha and Krishna in Vrindavan, and it says the Bhagavat Marg, and then under that it's written Rag Bhakti. And then under that, there's a picture of a Murdanga and a printing press. So the ramifications of this logo are very great. We don't have a lot of time, but I would just like to say that if you ever get an opportunity to see that, you know, there's a lot of realizations that can come from that logo. But one of the things that I'd like to just share that came to me by seeing that was a statement Srila Prabhupada made, that in a wartime, an ordinary soldier can distinguish himself very greatly in the country simply by doing, you know, his duty as a soldier. So in the same way, Srila Prabhupada mentioned that a devotee can become recognized by Lord Chaitanya and Lord Krishna by performing this book distribution, by performing the Sankirtan. So if we can glean from this that it's very important activity that Srila Prabhupada wanted us to perform, because he wanted us to quickly become purified so that we can get out of this miserable material world and go back home, back to Godhead. Hare Krishna.
So before we begin with the awards, last person speaking is His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj. So for those of you who do not know Maharaj has many responsibilities, many designations, many wonderful qualities. He's a wonderful preacher, wonderful writer, a wonderful manager, wonderful katha speaker. But for us here in Mayapur, especially in our Sankirtan department, we see His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj as our Sankirtan leader. His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj ki.
I'll be very brief, because this is not a Sankirtan seminars to tell you stories. It's more important we distribute awards for preachers. But all I can say, the best and blissful part of my devotional life in ISKCON is that when I live with brahmacharis who are doing Sankirtan, I live in the same building, always surrounded by Sankirtan brahmacharis, so much blissful. I observe them throughout the year, how they go out, throughout the year. In Mayapur, we don't have December marathon. We have 12 months marathon. And I see when sometimes I go to with them also, they live practically like gypsies. You know gypsies? Gypsy life. The one bujka bag, that's it, their sampad. The way they sleep, they travel, they eat. You see, you'll cry, the life they maintain. But when they come to Mayapur, I see they're always very blissful. They're very healthy also, they take good prasad. But always very blissful. So I see how that happens. So that shows if somebody will be engaged in Sankirtan, and how his life is always blissful. When they come to Mayapur, so many seminars, always I go room to the reading books, learning verses. It's a blissful life. So I'm very much indebted to Mayapur Brahmacharis. We have about 100 Brahmacharis constantly distributing books. And we have more than 250 Brahmacharis, including our Namahatta, Bhakti Virikha, Gita course, throughout the years, that's always staying in the field for distributing books and for doing their respective preaching programs. So we are very, very thankful to all these Brahmacharis. Please bless them so they can distribute more and more books. Usually, last few years, we are in first position. But this year, Mayapur is in second position. The big difference with Delhi. So all I humbly request Maharaj to bless us so we can come in first position next year also. Thank you so much.
Actually, we come here to get blessed by Mayapur devotees. I just have a small request. We have two or three devotees in the assembly here who are very good book distributors. We've been distributing books for a long time. We have Amrish Maharaj. He has been distributing books in Russia for 30 years non-stop. Maybe he can speak a few words.
Hanuman is here.
Yeah. Hanuman. And we have Mother Sundar, who is the number one book distributor in the world.
Where is Hanuman?
Can they speak one minute? Just 1 minute.
Hare Krishna. Bhima Prabhu spoke about logo of Gaudiya Math, and when Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur opened this temple in Chaitanya Math, he established this printing press just opposite the Gandharvika Giridhari Ditis, and every morning all the inhabitants of this mat, they were coming together and they were offering pujat to this printing press, and they were offering flowers to this press, and they were chanting kirtan. And Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he said that the sound produced by this printing press is the best kirtan for Gandharvika Giridhari. So this is so important service that was stressed by our acharyas, so we can get unlimited mercy by taking part in this service, so we have to do it.
So Madhusudan Prabhu is here with us. He's one of the top book distributors in the world. So he will speak in Hindi.
Hare Krishna. So हम लोग ये पुस्तक वितरण करते हैं पूरे साल. महाराज की कृपा से महाराज ने आज्ञा दिया कि हम लोग ट्रैवलिंग संकीर्तन करें. तो अभी हमारे साथ लगभग 10 डिवोटी हैं जो ट्रैवलिंग संकीर्तन करते हैं. और महाराज ने स्पेशल आशीर्वाद दिया है. तो पूरे साल जो है हम लोग जाते हैं अलग अलग जगहों पे. अभी हम लोग साउथ इंडिया में बुक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कर रहे हैं. तो ये सब गुरु महाराज का ही आशीर्वाद है. चल
अबाउट 10 डिवोटीज इन दिल्ली बाई महाराज मर्सी एंड ऑर्डर. दे आर गोइंग ऑल ओवर इंडिया. दे जस्ट गोइंग टू साउथ इंडिया ऑल्सो. So Prabhu, they're very encouraged to distribute books. Prabhu is one of the best book distributors. There's one more Hanuman Prabhu, I don't see him. He also distributes in corporate.
Hanuman, go ahead.
So thank you very much to all.
So we'll be happy to hear and see that this Urdu Gita I'm published in Pakistan, Karachi. Modi showed it to Modi. Modi was very happy to see Urdu Gita in Pakistan.
Modi was very happy to see our Gita exhibited for about 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. The Prime Minister had come to our Delhi temple to release the astounding Gita produced in Italy. So we also showed him Prabhupada's Gita translated in about 45 languages. He was very impressed by that.
So as Bhima Prabhu mentioned, there's two types of practice of devotional service. So this is the Sankirtan event. It's very spontaneously organized. So we will have now the international awards given out by Vijay Prabhu to the various temples there. So we will give a mic to Vijay Prabhu and we will request him to recognize the various contributions of the temples all over the world to this Sankirtan effort.
Hare Krishna. So there's seven continents where we're distributing books now. So the top three temples in each continent, we're going to give an award to. Okay, so this is Australasia. The number three temple in Australasia with 21,828 book points is Wellington, New Zealand. Anybody here from New Zealand? Is this a New Zealand devotee coming here?
No.
No. Vasu Streisa. Is he here? Okay. Anyway, I'm going to New Zealand. I'll give it to him. Huh? Okay. So hang around, Vasu Streisa. This is he's a disciple of Srila Prabhupada. Distributed books for many years in Australia. Don't go anywhere, Vasu. We have more for you. So number two in Australasia, with 22,053 book points, Auckland Lofts, New Zealand. And number three in Australasia, for the first time that I've ever seen, number one in Australasia, with 28,827 book points, Melbourne, Australia. Someone here from Australia? No. So the next continent is Africa. The number three temple in Africa with 11,256 book points, Kisumu, Kenya. Anybody here from Africa? Ah, yes. Come. Number two in Africa with 29,405 book points, Durban, South Africa. Number one temple in Africa with 57,932 book points, Nairobi, Kenya. And this devotee gets all of them. Are you a book distributor also? Haribo! Okay, the continent of Europe. The number three temple in Europe with 58,089 book points, Sankirtan Dham in Italy. Anybody here from Italy? Okay, see the book distributors are all fired up out there. They don't come to Mayapur Festival. Okay, number two in Europe with 66,469 book points, Bhaktivedanta Manor, England. Anybody here from the manor? Here we go. There's such a big competition between the Bhaktivedanta Manor and Soho. They're so close every year. Thank you. So number one temple in Europe with 69,872 book points, London, Soho, England. Okay, she's representing Europe or England. Okay, the number three temple in South America with 26,955 book points, Mexico City. Anybody here from Mexico? Okay, here we go. Hare Krishna. You might want to hang around. There might be more for you here. Oh no, this is Brazil. Number two, temple in South America with 66,673 book points, Nittai Gauranga Traveling Sankirtan Party, Brazil. Actually, what's really interesting about this is that actually this is just one devotee. It's not a temple, it's one devotee. That's not him. Actually, his name is Chaitanya Chandra. Oh, we got a garland for you. This one devotee goes out every day and he distributes about 400 books every day. Unbelievable. So, number one temple in South America with 69,310 book points, Guaramaro, Mexico. Anybody here from around Guaramaro, Mexico? Yeah? Come. Take another one. Okay, now with Russia. Number three temple in Russia with 28,539 book points, St. Petersburg. There's Russians. Number two temple in Russia with 38,347 book points, Moscow Goloka Dham. Maharaj is not from Moscow Goloka Dham, but he travels all over Russia distributing books. The number one temple in Russia with 150,966 book points. Prabhupada would be so pleased, wouldn't he? Moscow, Russia! Prabhupada is the one that opened Russia. Amazing, huh? So now, in the USA, the number three temple with 92,999 book points, RVC. Rupanuga Vedic College, RVC. Parameshwar Prabhu is accepting the award here, and he's the general of this Sankirtan army. He's been distributing books for the past how many years? 21 years.
He also distributes a lot of Arabic books.
And he distributes a lot of Arabic books. So he's getting a lot of mercy from Lord Chaitanya, Srila Prabhupada. Thank you. The number two temple in the USA with 178,569 book points, Silicon Valley. Anybody here from the Silicon Valley? They're all distributing books. I'll give it to them. Okay, the number one temple in the USA with 207,297 book points, Los Angeles, California. There's a devotee here that's been distributing books in Los Angeles for the past 40 years. His name is Sachi Tenoy Prabhu, and he will receive the award. Sachi Tenoy Prabhu, come. 4 decades he's been distributing books. 66 years old, and he continues. Thank you. Yeah. Now, we go into the big time. The number 3 temple in Asia, with 717,428 book points, New Delhi, Punjabi Bagh. There was just a devotee here, sitting here just now. Where is he? He's from Punjabi Bagh. Where is he? Where'd he go? Book distributor. Come on. Somebody from Punjabi Bagh, come. Book distributor. Come on. Don't be shy. Just now coming. There he is. Let him get through. He's a big book distributor. How many years have you been distributing books? 10 years. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Now, this competition between Mayapur and New Delhi is just getting amazing. Every year, you know, one year it's Mayapur, next year it's New Delhi, then it's Mayapur. It's an unbelievable, amazing competition. Nice, friendly competition. You know? Prabhupada liked the competition. He said, even in the spiritual world, there's competition. So, the number 2 temple in Asia with 1,157,681 book points, Mayapur, India. I mean, it's completely amazing that such a high score is second place. This has never happened before. Unbelievable. Now wait till you hear this score. The number 1 temple in Asia with 1,850,252 book points, New Delhi, India. Thank you. And you know, the recognition for all this amazing book distribution goes to Gopal Krishna Maharaj. He's completely fixed on Prabhupada's desire that book distribution increase and increase and increase. Because he got so much instruction from Prabhupada about book distribution. So it went into his heart and it never left. Gopal Krishna Maharaj ki. Yeah.
So now we will give awards to our Mayapur devotees. So at 10th place here in Mayapur, we have Mayapur Chandradaya Prabhu. Please come in line. Everybody come in line. Be ready so we move fast. So 10th place, Mayapur. So from Mayapur, we will go by, we have 3 categories of awards. We have top 10 book distributors, then we have our bus leaders and top Mayapur departments, book distribution departments. So we will go in that way. We will try to move fast as well, because we have many people. So on the 10th place, Mayapur Chandrodaya Das with 1,472 book points. Ribo! Manoram Prabhu. Manoram Prabhu, next. On the 9th place, Manoram Gaur Prabhu, 14,965 book points. Eighth place, Sadhu Sevak Nitai Prabhu. Arivo! 21,789 book points. Seventh place, Tapasvi Krishna Prabhu, 22,384 book points. Sixth place, Tushtaram Prabhu. Rivo! 27,190 book points. Fifth place, Kamal Narayan Prabhu. Rivo! 29,380 book points. Fourth place, Sankirtan Yuga Dharma Prabhu. Arivo! 35,720 book points. Third place, Ananta Ananda Gaur Prabhu. Arivo! 49,844 book points. Arivo! Second place, Patit Udhar Gobinda Prabhu. Arivo! 51,718 book points. First place, Tushta Baladev Prabhu. Arivo! 95,428 book points. Arivo!
Next one.
Next, we have our bus leaders and buses. So, on the 10th place, bus number 9, Gopaleshwar Prabhu. Haribo! 1, TSKP1, Subandhu Madhav Prabhu. Haribo! 7th place, TSKP 10, Brajeshwar Prabhu. Next, 6th place, TSKP 2, Bahupur Jagannath Prabhu. 1, Gopal Balak Prabhu, TSKP 8. On the 5th place, TSKP 6, Dina Dayal Gopal Prabhu. Next, TSKP 3, on the 4th place, Shukamai Vishwambar Prabhu. On the 3rd place, TSKP 7, Achutananda Gaur Prabhu. With 60,716 book points. Second place, TSKP 4, Banamali Mukunda Prabhu, with 67,214 book points. and on the first place, our top bus, TSKP 5, Udar Gaur Sundar Prabhu Haribo, with 229,86,000 book points. Haribo. So Mayapur, one of the reasons in Mayapur why we have a good book scores is not just because Sankirtan party is there, but because all Mayapur departments participate in book distribution. Haribo! So it's a very, very good practice. Please encourage in your temples. All departments have to participate in book distribution. So we would like to extend our special thanks to various Mayapur departments for their participation. And Jaya Pataka Maharaj, yes. Yes, we will thank at the end. So we go all the way from 19? So on the 19th spot, IYF Mayapur, Rivo. On the 18th, Bhaktivedanta National School. On 17th, Mayapur Tourism Department. On the 16th spot, Mayapur Central Department. On the 15th, Mayapur Goshala. On the 14th place, Nitya Kishori Mataji Sankirtan Group. On the 13th place, Mayapur Guest House Department. On the 12th spot, Mayapur Land Department. On the 11th spot, Mayapur Bhishma Department. On the 10th spot, Mayapur Life Membership Department. On the 9th spot, Mayapur Rajpur Jagannath Temple. On the 8th spot, Mayapur Bhakti Vriksha Department. On the 7th spot, Mayapur School Preaching Department. On the 6th spot, Jayapataka Maharaj's office. And those who are present here from those different departments, please come. We will like to offer you garland and chandan. Please come forward if you are here. On the 5th spot, Jayapataka Maharaja's servant group. On the 4th spot, Mayapur BBT. On the 3rd spot, Srila Prabhupada Pushpa Samadhi Department with 32,780 book points. On the 2nd spot, Mayapur Gita Study Course Department with 48,250 book points. On the 1st spot, Mayapur Namahata Department with 229,775 book points. Haribo! Anybody from Namahata here? From Gita Study Course, anybody here? Anyway, our special thanks to from Mayapur. Some departments are not mentioned. Many great individuals are not mentioned, but we would like to thank all of you, fall at your feet, for participating and distributing books with us here in Mayapur. So now we will go our special thanks to His Grace Jivanath Prabhu. Haribo! So Jivanath Prabhu is part of our transcendental Sankirtan family here in Mayapur. We all love him very much. He's a very senior Prabhupada disciple who very enthusiastically distributes books here in Mayapur. Haribo! And what we love about him, that last year he specifically oversees book distribution here in the morning after Mangal Arati. So in 1 year, what he did, when he took over that, he doubled it, and then he doubled it again. Haribo! Pramanjana Prabhu from Bhaktivedanta National School, please come. Our National School also very enthusiastically participates. Pramanjana Prabhu is the school principal there. So next, our special thanks to His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj. So as all of you know, Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj stays in the Sankirtan building with the Sankirtan devotees all the time when he is here. And also special thanks to His Holiness Jayapataka Maharaj. Some of you may not know, but His Holiness Jayapataka Maharaj is very intimately involved in Mayapur book distribution. He's always in touch with Sankirtan devotees, regularly sends messages, regularly asks for book scores. Very, very much he keeps his hand on the pulse of Mayapur Sankirtan and constantly inspires devotees here to participate in the book distribution. And he himself also a big book distributor here in Mayapur.
Hare Krishna. When Maharaj is in hospital, from hospital he calls Sankirtan bus leader to encourage them.
Hare Krishna.
So on behalf of Jayapataka Maharaj, we will give the certificate and the garland to His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj. Haribo! So His Holiness Jayapataka Maharaj was not able to participate, but we have a short message from Maharaj to all the devotees and all our Mayapur book distributors. So we will play it now.
I must mention one devotee name who is really giving energy, practically guiding for book distribution, personally distributing books, collecting a lot of sponsorship. His Grace Venudhari Das Brahmachari. And also, behind all the Sankirtan effort, I have put And behind all this book distribution, that we get all support from our MAC representative and chairman, Subhakshan Das Prabhu. As Subhakshan Prabhu said, the book distribution in Mayapur is so great because the Mayapur management gives full support and most importance for this book distribution. So that is one reason why book is so great here in Mayapur. Haribol.
We want to invite Hrida Chaitanya Prabhu, who is the co-director for 6 months and who is working very hard to see Mayapur develop.
Hrida Chaitanya Prabhu is Mayapur GBC, MEB member and also MAC co-chairman. He always silently supports and helps book distribution. He is in charge of our whole master plan also. 6 months, he's the only one Mayapur management person who 6 months does not go out of Mayapur and stay here and serve. Hrida Chaitanya Prabhu, okay. Okay, message from Jayapatak Maharaj, Haribol.
Jayapataka, Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale, Srivati Bhakti Vedanta, Swami Niti Namane. Saraswati Devi Saravati Pacharide Nirvishesha Sunnavadi Vasatya Dasatharine
Namaste Saraswati Devi
Saravati
Pacharide Nirvishesha Sunnavadi
So I'm very glad to hear that the book distribution awards and achievements are being focused on this morning.
So I am very glad to hear that the achievements of book distribution are focused on this morning.
Srila Prabhupada said that if you wanted to please him, one way was to distribute books.
Srila Prabhupada said, if we want to please him, one way was to distribute his books.
Books are the basis.
Books are the basis.
And he wanted the devotees to not only distribute the books, but to read and study them.
And Srila Prabhupada wanted that the devotees should not only distribute the books but should read them and study them.
So, we're very glad that devotees are distributing and studying Prabhupada's teachings in his books.
So we are very glad that the devotees are studying and distributing Srila Prabhupada's teachings in his books.
And that they are also studying.
And that they are also studying.
If we talk to someone, we can only spend a few minutes.
If we can talk to someone, we can spend only a few minutes.
But if they take one of Srila Prabhupada's transcendental literatures, they'll read for many hours and days.
They'll read for many hours and days.
And thus get association with Srila Prabhupada.
And thus get association with Srila Prabhupada.
Also, the books are incarnations of Lord Krishna.
The books are the incarnations of Lord Krishna.
Lord Chaitanya said, Koro Krishna Shiksha.
Lord Chaitanya said, Koro Krishna Shiksha.
And the Bhagavad Gita is the words of Lord Krishna directly.
And Bhagavad Gita is the words of Lord Krishna directly.
And Srimad Bhagavatam is the glories of Krishna by his devotees.
And Srimad Bhagavatam is the glories of Krishna by his devotees.
Chaitanya Charitamrita glorifies Krishna's mercy incarnation, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Chaitanya Charitamrita glorifies incarnation of Krishna as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
The most merciful avatar.
The most merciful avatar.
Take away by Chibubane Nai Amana Dayala Dada.
Take away by Chibubane Nai Amana Dayala Dada.
Pasil Paki Jure Asana Dhirade Sunita Gona Gata
Pasupa Kijure Prasana Bidure Sunejaro Gona Gata.
Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful in the three worlds.
Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful in the three worlds.
And even the animals were crying and chanting the holy names.
Even the animals were crying and chanting the holy names.
And even the stones melted with his touch.
And even the stone melted with his touch.
So these glories of Lord Chaitanya are given in the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
So these glories of Lord Chaitanya are given in this Chaitanya Charitamrita.
So distributing Prabhupada's transcendental literature gives people a touch of the Lord's mercy.
So distributing Srila Prabhupada's literatures gives people a touch of Lord's mercy.
I thank all of you very much for your dedication to distributing Prabhupada's teachings.
So I would like to thank you all for your dedication in distributing Srila Prabhupada's teachings.
Giving this Krishna's teachings in the form of Gita, Bhagavatam, and Chaitanya Charitamrita.
Giving these Krishna's teachings in the form of Bhagavad Gita and Chaitanya Charitamrita.
So thank you very much, Haribo.
Haribo, His Holiness Japataka Maharaj Ki Jai. So we're just about to close this transcendental event. So at the end, we would like to request Jivanath Prabhu. Jivanath Prabhu, besides being a wonderful Sankirtan devotee, he's also a very highly empowered announcer. So,
Hare Krishna! I'll wake you up a little bit. So we just wanted to thank just a few devotees. These three devotees organize all our 10 buses. And so they do an amazing job. We want to thank them. Prema Bhakti Prakash Prabhu, Subarna Gore Prabhu, Rajeshwar Gopal Prabhu. Haribo! And I noticed not one devotee from Delhi said Haribo. They're like, no, I'm thanking those guys. They're doing too good. Okay. Now here's who organizes the buses, the bus leaders, all of our Sankirtan here in Sri Dhama Mayapur. Gordam Prabhu, Haribo! Please stand up. Please stand up. This is him right here. The Delhi guys are throwing daggers. Okay. So we'd just like to thank our esteemed guest. Okay. We want to thank all our speakers today and our esteemed guests and everybody who attended. And we'll even thank the devotees from New Delhi for beating us this year. This year. This year. You guys listening to this? Oh, you guys, I hope you can understand English. Delhi beat us this year. We won last year. That's ancient history. Well, let's make New Delhi ancient history for next year by hoping, praying, and working very hard. Excuse me, Maharaj, aren't you one of us too? Don't you wear two hats?
Great. Oh, you said Mayapur should definitely try to defeat Delhi.
Okay. Did you hear that? He wants Mayapur to win. All right, so we're on the right page.
The key word is he said try.
Try. He wants us to try. Ooh, ooh. Did you guys hear that? He wants us to try. Like, good luck, you losers. No. We're going to win. Do you hear me, Mayapur? All of Mayapur, let's get it together and win for next year so that we don't have to say we came in second. All right. We'll leave everybody to go outside. You can take some prasadam outside in the courtyard over here. There is prasadam for everybody who manages to stay. Sri Dhama Mayapur ki jai! Srila Prabhupada's book distribution ki jai! Nitai Gora!